Watch yourself. Ryan's stirring. We best keep to our knitting. It's time to either run the table or go home empty. Ryan's got the genetic key to Rapture. We get that from him and we get out of this hellhole. We don't, then you and I are ghosts. Now would you kindly head to Ryan's office and kill the son of a bitch? It's time to finish this.
I say Cohen's lost his touch, if you knew him. He used to believe in the work, in the struggle. And now, he rots in that Neverland, waiting for someone to come and tell him he still got it. I suppose it's right that he has.
In due time, he says.
I've resigned from the council and lodged me letter of protest, but that's just pissing in the wind. It'll be war, I say. Unless somebody stops Ryan. Right fast.
Welcome.
Adam looks up and sees the face of God. But look around. It's a regular convention of worms in here. They all had mothers, fathers, people who loved them. They got married, their wives. What makes you think you're any different? I haven't chosen the spot for you on the wall yet. Let me know if you have a preference.
I spent the afternoon trying to get as close to Ryan's gate as possible without making a spectacle of myself. He's got it shielded six ways to Leicester. There's no way into that place. All I got for my trouble was the hairy eyeball from Ryan's splicer mates. That's the reward you get for trying to outsmart the best electrical engineer of our generation.
What is the difference between a man and a parasite? A man builds, a parasite asks, "Where's my share?" A man creates, a parasite says, "What will the neighbors think?" A man invents, a parasite says, "Watch out, or you might tread on the toes of God."
For 3 weeks, but he finally spilled the beans on how to get to Andrew Ryan. Generate a sympathetic overload in harmonic chord number 3. That's simple. Now all I gotta do is figure out what the hell a sympathetic overload is, and for that matter, a harmonic chord number 3. Piece of cake for an electrical engineer. Too bad I designed ladies' shoes. Gonna go see the grease monkeys left alive in heat loss monitoring. See what I can shake out of their trees.
Like all parasites who ever tried to walk in stolen shoes. I'd explain the science that renders what you're trying to do impossible, but that would be like playing Mozart for a tree frog. Opening the schools, humming the thoughts of young minds. My city will live. My city will thrive. And when that day comes, use your tombstone to pick the tiles.
Terrible thing, and thank done you. Worse myself. Thank you for reminding me that the light of the world has not yet been snuffed out. I am sending a little one to help you on your way.
But this is what things come to.
I don't know
if killing Mr. Ryan will stop the war. But I know it won't stop while that man breathes. I love Mr. Ryan. Well, I love Rapture. If I have to kill one to save the other, so do you.
Strikes me that Fontaine wasn't overly inconvenienced by his own demise. On New Year's Eve, these wretched splicers come streaming out of the poorhouses and storm the proverbial barricades. Dead rot in the streets. Johnny and Jamie Citizen are lined up round the block for plasmids. Anything to help fend off the rabble.
Do you guys have any idea there's a war on? If you don't follow proper maintenance of all these batteries, they burn through those R-34s like them Eve's apple berries go through penicillin. I've got Atlas's goons hitting us non-stop and 2 dead mechanics just this week. We need to control costs. If I wanted to deal with amateurs, I would have stayed on dry land.
Repent!
Of the sea insanity. But where else could we be free from the clutching hand of the parasites? Where else could we build an economy that they would not try to control, a society that they would not try to destroy? It was not impossible to capture at the bottom of the sea.
Come back when you get
it was impossible
money,
to build it anywhere else.
You ungrateful bastard! He offered you salvation! You shall know!
Thank you.
imagine the will it took to create a place like this. And what have you built? Nothing. You can only loot and break. You're not a man. You're just a termite adversary. Has eaten the last gram of you. Rapture will have returned. I will see the parade. Who was that, they'll say, as they point to the sad shape hanging on my wall. Who was that?
Costa!
I'll beg Mr. Ryan to hand Fontaine Futuristics over to Atlas's boys as a peace offering. But the stupid sod won't listen to reason. Instead, he's just splicing his mob up, giving them more and tougher plasmids. There's an arms race on here, in Rapture. But it's not about who can build the best guns and the biggest bombs. It's about who can become less of a man and more of a monster.
I didn't recognize the twist that come into the shop today. Stacked like Sally. And dressed to the nines. She's playing her cards pretty close to the vest, but you ain't gotta be no college job to see that she's into some bad china. She was asking about magnetic locks and some such. I played it coy, but she took once. After she showed me round her backyard, I gave her directions to Keyboard's tool shop. Rapture's gone to hell, but sometimes The great chain still cuts you a break.
Welcome to the Circus of Value.
Man builds a city at the bottom of the sea. That's a marvel. Another man happens to be on a plane that crash lands on the same city in the middle of the ocean. Why, that sounds more like a miracle.
Thank you. Time for a nap, sweet angel. I've heard it all before, but let me right away say, by me a sin to shame means that you're brain. By me a fist to shame is such an old refrain, and yet I should explain, it means I am begging for your hand.
Chosen to destroy themselves with careless splicing, undeniable. But I will make no proclamations. I will dictate no laws. The great chain moves slowly, but with wisdom. It is our impatience that invites in the parasite of big government. And once you've invited it in, it will never stop feeding on the body of the city.
Nitroglycerin in my office, that will serve as the catalyst. Now I need a 4R34 lead shield wire stubs to pass the circuit. Then a half can of ionic gel, that's the Pretty Betty of the mix. Should send the core into compensation mode, push power down the line and trigger the circuit breaker on Ryan's gate. Well, that's the theory. It'll either work like a charm or blow up half of Rapture. Nothing ventured.
Thank you.
sent his parasites.
Ocean's got an itch to retake this corner of Rapture. This happened right after the start of the war. Read about it in the papers. Head on in. I'll see what I can dig up to help. I'm no engineer, but if I read these plans right, you can channel that magma flow using the redirect valve. It'll boil off that water right quick, and you'll be able to reach the core. Orion's sure to take notice. Might want to set up a perimeter just to be certain.
from your family, from your friends, from everything you ever loved. And for some reason, you like it here. You feel something you can't quite put your finger on. Think about it for a second, and maybe the word will come to you. Nostalgia. Offer you a piece of my plundered city? Mark my words, your only reward will be a knife in the back.
Even in the book of lies, sometimes you find truth. There is indeed a season for all things. And now that I see you flesh to flesh and blood to blood, I know I cannot raise my hand against you. But know this, you are my greatest disappointment. Does your master hear me? Atlas, you can kill me, but you will never have my city. My strength is not in steel and fire. That is what the parasites will never understand. A season for all things. A time to live and a time to die. A time to build and a time to destroy! Come now, my child.
What? Ryan set the core to self-destruct. This is different than what you did. He's got a mind to take down the whole damn city. Get in there and whack the chunk before the whole joint blows!
Oh. deployment, Lot 111, Dr. Sucho, client Fontaine Futuristics. Baby is now a year old, weighs 58 pounds, and possesses gross musculature of a fit 19-year-old. The results are disappointing, but within expected tolerances. Did you that to your puppy? She's very pretty.
Thank you, puppy.
Break her neck for me.
What?
Break that sweet puppy's neck. No, please. Break that puppy's neck, would you kindly?
No.
Assassin has overcome my final defense, and now he's come to murder me. In the end, what separates a man from a slave? Money? Power? No. A man chooses. A slave obeys. You think you have memories? A farm. A family, an airplane, a crash, and then this place. Was there really a family? Did that airplane crash, or was it hijacked? Forced down by something less than a man, something bred to sleepwalk through life until they are activated by a simple phrase spoken by their kindly master. Was a man sent to kill or a slave? A man chooses. A slave obeys. Come in. Stop, would you kindly? Would you kindly? Powerful phrase. Familiar phrase.
Would you kindly get this? Would you kindly find that? Would you kindly find that? Would you kindly find that? Would you kindly get this? Would you kindly head to Ryan's office and kill the son of a bitch?
Sit, would you kindly? Stand, would you kindly? Run! Stop! Turn. A man chooses. A slave obeys. Kill! Juices!
Thank you.
ever was. Cell in my line of work takes on a variety of aliases. Hell, once I was even a Chinaman for 6 months. But you've been a sworn, so I guess I owe you a little honesty. The name's Frank Fontaine.
I gotta say, I had a lot of business partners in my life, but you, of course, the fact that you were genetically conditioned to bark like a cocker spaniel when I said, would you kindly, might have had something to do with it, but still. Now, as soon as that machine finishes processing the genetic key you just fished off, Ryan, I'm gonna run Rapture. Tits to toes. You better pal. You know what they say? Never mix business with friendship. Thanks for everything, kid. Don't forget to say hi to Ryan for me.
Welcome back, child. Welcome to the city where you were born. You are angry at Fontaine, yes? Now you know the truth. You are his tool, brought back to Rapture to save him. You have saved many of my little ones. I owe you a debt. While you sleep, I undo some of Fontaine's mental conditioning. His control is no longer complete, but he can still pull some very unpleasant strings. We made your mind with many locks and keys. Fontaine has most of those keys, but not all. Su-chan designed your mind, taught Fontaine to control you. You might find answers in Su-chan's flat in Mercury Suite.
Oh, man.